Fate had a hand in this video. We've been through the Wick area on several occasions, but never really stopped to look around. After my wife had badly twisted her ankle earlier in the week,
nurses make the worst patients.
A visit to Caithness General Hospital in Wick was thrust upon us. Thankfully nothing broken, but walking any distance was now out of the question. As the day was getting on, we travelled a short distance to Noss Head and discovered the ruins of Castle Sinclair Girnigoe. I got some drone footage in the evening light. That's further along in the video. The following morning was a windy one, so no more flying. But I had a good walk around this amazing castle ruin. There are plenty of signs around the ruins, with artist impressions of how it all used to be. The castle was built and modified by the Sinclair Earls of Caithness, who were one of Northern Scotland's most powerful families, building from the 14th century right into the 17th century. It was once thought that the site comprised of two castles, though excavations and research have concluded that it was in fact one fortress which has been added to and modified along the way, resulting in what is left today.
Toilet with a view.
A later dispute over the Earl of Caithness title culminated in George Sinclair and a group of men to strip the castle of furniture, doors, roofs and floors. The wrecked castle passed into the Dunbar family around 1700, but was never restored. The castle walls almost seamlessly joined the cliff. Consolidation work is ongoing to stop the remains tumbling into the sea. Parts of the castle ruin almost mirror the rugged sea stacks.